So, GV, in the last module, we saw this, you know, fairly complex database that Varsha had given us. And, you know, I hope the students have had a chance to look at some of this, you know, play around with the data. Because there are lots of columns, right? And of course, we can think of some cases where some of these columns are useful, but we have not used most of these columns, but that's okay. I think, you know, maybe some other cases we will use some of these columns.
Correct. Depends on today, application.
And then in the last module, we had also learned how to use COUNTIF and COUNTIF with multiple conditions. In this module, what we'll do is we'll look at the channel effectiveness criteria. If you remember, in when we were discussing with Varsha, what she told us was that Ritesh, one of the problems he's facing is, you know, occasionally he's not getting enough profiles. And then he has to figure out which is the best channel for him to focus more of his energies on, right?
Correct.
So now, I think today, let's figure out, how do we figure out what is the best channel for Ritesh to work on? Okay.
So the first thing, criteria.
So there are some criteria. I think what Varsha was saying, and she was not very certain about the criteria, but she said broadly look at some of these.
Okay.
Look at how many applications are you getting from each channel? And she is suggesting that you should look at not just what are the total number of applications you got from a channel, but also on a week basis, on a weekly basis, how many
applications. Is there a column that tells you, I mean, can you find out weekly basis? Is there a column for that somewhere?
So that is an interesting question. Okay. So if you go to the application data, you will see that there is no such column.
There is a date of application.
There is date of application, but there is no column which says week.
You have to get it from that date of application.
Okay. So the way we do it is let's insert a column here. And we will call it week. And then what we do is.
So this is similar to that earlier case. In the earlier case also we did something like this. We need quarter one, quarter two, and all that we interesting stuff we introduced.
Correct. So in this case, what we will do is we will use week number. And that will tell us.
Week num. Yeah. Week num, not week.
Week num. This is week num. Right. Week num. Yeah. This has to be then formatted as a number. So this came in week three.
Week three, okay.
Now, if I drag this out, you will see some profiles are coming in week three, some are week four, etc.
Interesting. Everything that Excel seems to have, or you know, I mean, these spreadsheets seem to have a method of doing anything that you want, typically.
So, I guess, you know, these are fairly common. Analysis that people need to do, GV. That is why some of these functions are built in, no?
Yeah.
So this week-wise view seems to be one common thing that people are doing.
Week-wise, right? Yeah. Week-wise, month-wise.
Yeah. Correct. Week-wise, month-wise, quarter-wise.
Yeah.
So now, if you look at this column, then we will know in which week we got the profile.
Now you can count. Count if week is three, week is one, week is two, same thing. Make a column with remove duplicates, all that, and do a count if. Okay.
Correct. So one criteria she said was look at number of applications from the channel, both total and on a weekly basis.
Okay.
Second is look at candidate qualification, degree plus years of experience. The third criteria she looked at was aging, which is how long does the application last before we are able to process it.
No, degree plus experience. Okay, so there are so many degrees, right? But what do you mean by candidate qualification across the channel? Means are we getting more experienced people or not? That I understand. Yes. Because that's a number, yes. Right? But unless you say which degrees you prefer, what does it mean to say get what degrees am I getting from the channel?
They do have, I think, in their mind, they have some notion of which degree they prefer.
Okay. So you have some selected degrees that you're looking for, and you want some number of years of experience. And are you getting that number of years of experience of that degree or those set of degrees from that channel? All right. Get it. Okay.
Yeah. So, and I think for each position, some of the criteria on effectiveness of channel may be different. Okay.
Okay.
So, this what Varsha has told us is in general for all kinds of positions. For our selection criteria, we must figure out which criteria are relevant out of these.
Can't we just look at the average experience that we're getting from a channel and then use that? That's good enough, no?
We could. But in this particular case, when I was talking to Varsha, she said there were two or three things that were important. Was how many applications are we getting and at what weekly rate? Second, she said was important. What was important to her was how many of the applications that came in got shortlisted. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So if 100 applications from third party, how many got shortlisted?
Yeah.
And the third thing, and this was something also very interesting for me, GD, the company, Tech Enterprises, seems to take into consideration how easy was it for the candidate to apply through this channel. I think the assumption is that if the channel makes it difficult, okay, so if I go to Tech Enterprises website and the format there for applying is very difficult, then it will tend to dissuade people. So the third criteria that they seem to be looking at is ease of application. How easy was it to apply?
And that is based on feedback. You have this feedback column.
We have that column which says how easy was it to apply.
Apply, okay. But this, number of applications matching GD and CD. How do you do that? I mean, this is very descriptive, right? How do you know it matches?
So the way I think what Varsha said is that the way to look at it is if the application matches the JD, then it will be shortlisted. So that is just another way of saying
the number of it. So then it's redundant, right? So
it's redundant, yes. Yes, it is redundant.
Remove it, then let's remove it because so then it doesn't clutter our space. Okay.
And also in our case, these two don't seem to be very important as per Russia. So we can just make them blue because they don't seem to be relevant for us.
Okay, let's leave it. Yeah. Because I think aging, I don't even know what it is, but anyway, leave it.
Correct.
Aging.
Correct.
Okay. Mm-hmm. If it's not relevant, why even bother? Let's not bother.
Yeah.
Okay. So these are, I think these, what is remaining is very easy to measure. We already seen, right? Channel wise application count weekly.
Yes.
We already have a column we just created, just have to count it. Shortlist, we already gave us an assignment last time. Right? That's the assignment you gave, no? Oh, but channel wise. Channel wise. That we did gender. So we want to do shortlisted channel wise. All right, cool. And then we want to do ease of application, which is feedback. All right, good. I think all of them we can do.
So let's go through it. Okay, one by one.
Parameters or what is it? We want to give parameter all equally weighted?
Sorry?
All these three criteria are equally weighted? Or?
We will, when we come to the composite score, when it comes to composing the composite score, we will, that is a conversation we will need to have.
All right. Okay.